You're unmuted, so go for it.
All right. Hey, Sasha, how you doing?
Good. How are you?
Good. Just what do you, I guess, kind of expect from Notre Dame?
I mean, obviously, they're really, really well-coached team. They have a lot of good players, a lot of good talent on their team. They have a lot of different options. They're really good offensively and everything like that. And yeah, they're a great team. They've had a lot of tough games so far early in the season, and they're a good team.
What did you guys take from the Ohio State game in terms of proving to yourselves what you're capable of at both ends of the floor, I guess?
Yeah, it's just doing our job. I think we did a good job of that in that Ohio State game, and you know, just executing on both ends of the floor and making sure that we know our scouting report game plan really well, and you know, just continually doing that each game.
Mm-hmm. Ohio State gave you guys a lot of problems last year with their defense, but you guys were able to execute at a pretty high level there when you really had to. Just did you see growth, the sort of growth you wanted to kind of see, especially from your guards, you know, this season?
I mean, yeah, we still turn the ball over way too much. We need some of those possessions back. And, you know, I think just maybe just executing, cutting hard, getting our catches where we needed them to be, helped us a little bit, get easier shots. And, you know, we limit our turnovers, we get more possessions, and I think it'll just help us moving forward.
You guys turn a corner defensively the other night?
You would hope so. I think really just knowing our scouting report, knowing what each players are capable of, and you know, we have the ability to do it. So making sure that we're always focused and concentrating on that end of the floor is really going to help us.
I'm good. Thank you, Sasha.
Yep. Thank you.
Carmen?
Hey, Sasha, just how important was it to get Jaden Ivey kind of back involved in the rotation and getting back on the floor as you guys, you know, I know Saturday's not a Big Ten game, but you'll be jumping in the Big Ten season full time after this.
Yeah, it's a big deal. He's going to be a really important part of our team and moving forward this year. And yeah, he's really aggressive on the offensive end of the floor. And I think you guys saw that the other night. And you know, defensively, he gives us a whole, you know, another athlete, another guy that can really get into the ball and jam people. And he just really helps us overall. He's a tremendous athlete. Really can score the ball. And he's going to give us valuable minutes going forward in the Big Ten season.
You know, with no fans, there's been a lot of talk about you guys just having to bring your own energy. Is he a guy that can help you, you know, bring that energy and you guys feed off that a little bit this season?
Yeah, definitely. I think the plays that he made the other night in the Ohio State game definitely, you know, helped us get momentum and get some runs going. And, you know, obviously it was his first game back in a while, so he's definitely a little nervous, a little energetic and everything like that, but that's good. That's something that we need for right now off the bench, and it really helped in that game. And I know he's going to do that, you know, moving forward within the Big Ten season.
You seem to have a lot of adrenaline.
Yeah, I don't blame him. You know, he was definitely chomping at the bit to get back after that injury. And you know, obviously he's still a freshman, so all these games, you know, just getting experience and everything like that. But he did a great job, and you know, he needs to bring that energy every time, and he's going to be really good.
How would you describe or sum up Travion's passing from the other night?
Yeah, I mean, like we've said it before, I think he's one of the best passing bigs probably in the country, definitely within the conference. But, you know, his ability to see the floor, especially when he's getting double teamed, is something that is really tremendous. Can't really teach it. It's just something that he's, you know, he has, you know, within his skill set. It's a unique talent, and you know, his ability to score on the post and make passes when he's double teamed is something that's huge for our team. And he really did a good job of it the other night.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Tom?
Hey, Sasha, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, thanks. You guys have had the luxury of being able to play every game so far this season and haven't had any COVID hiccup because of it, which is, you know, not a lot of teams can say that right now. But can you talk to me a little bit about just kind of how stressful that sort of daily grind is, especially the last few weeks when you guys have had to deal with a lot of stuff on your campus?
Yeah, it's just, you know, I think the Big Ten's done a good job with our whole daily testing and kind of eliminating the whole contact tracing and whole aspect side of it. But, you know, we're trying to do everything as normal as possible, at least in my eyes. I think nothing's really changed in terms of daily routines or anything like that. It's just, it's a whole different aspect of just making sure that you kind of, you know, distance yourself from other people and making sure that you stay healthy. And it's definitely been different. You know, I feel for those teams that have been out for a little bit and haven't been able to play consistently and practice consistently. It definitely hurts them a little bit, but you know, we've been lucky enough where we haven't had to go through any of those struggles. So it's definitely different, but, you know, we're adjusting.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Dakota, anything?
Yeah, yeah, real quick, Sasha. Oftentimes it seems like this Crossroad Classic is a turning point for you guys. I know after this game 2 years ago, you were 6-5, and then you went on a run and won the Big Ten Conference. What is it about this weekend, I guess, that is maybe a measuring stick for you guys to see where you're at just as a team before you really get into to conference play?
Yeah, it's just another quality non-conference opponent. Obviously, whoever you play, you know, whether it's Notre Dame or Butler within this, it's, you know, you're going to get a good competitor in that game. And it just shows you where you're at. Both teams are really tough, whoever you play that year. And they added a different thing that you may have not seen in your non-conference games so far. And, you know, yeah, within the past 2 years, we haven't really performed in it. And you kind of have to adjust from there and making sure that you don't make the same mistakes. So going in tomorrow, you just got to be ready to go from the jump and, you know, just be ready to play.
Thanks, man.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sasha. Oh, Brian's got one more. Brian,
yep. Just one more real quick. Sasha, this was the first time the other night you guys had a full roster. Just do you kind of view this now as we dealt with a whole bunch of stuff here the last couple months and now we finally have a chance to, A, grow as a team here and kind of show what we can do?
Yeah, definitely. I think when you finally have, you know, all your pieces together, you know, you don't really have any excuses or anything like that. You got to just got to get better every single day. I mean, there's a lot of teams that are going through similar things, people out and quarantines and being sick and hurt or whatever it is. But, you know, just for us, you know, finally getting everybody back, it really helps everything out. And hopefully we, you know, we can continue to get better and get some quality wins.
Thanks, Sasha.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sasha.
Thanks, guys.